The race between Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton is closer than ever as the two presidential hopefuls battle it out for the nomination. And on the GOP side, presumptive nominee John McCain has been launching attacks on both Obama and Clinton. So here to crunch the latest numbers in our Fox News Opinion Dynamics polls, Democratic pollster Bernard Whitman and Republican pollster Chris Wilson. Thank you both for being here. Bernard, I want to start with you and take a look at the latest polls that we have about the matchup between McCain and Obama first. As you look at the matchup here, you can see Obama gaining on McCain in percentage-wise. I mean, it's not a big spread, and it's just outside the margin of error. Then you compare that to the matchup between Clinton and McCain, and you can see that McCain still holds right there at the margin of error. Is that a dangerous sign for the Clinton campaign, those polls?
Well, I think it's a great sign, actually, for the Obama campaign. And one thing that we've seen in this election is it's almost impossible to get all the polls right. And one reason, it's hard to poll a phenomenon. But I will tell you this. When you have Obama beating McCain among independents, when you have Obama with nearly 1 in 5 Republicans saying they'd definitely vote for him, when you have Obama having the highest favorables of any candidate in the race, that bodes very well for the Democratic Party going into the fall election.
Chris, we have another interesting question about the most important candidate quality. We asked people to weigh in on that. And as you take a look at this, you can see the split between Democrats and Republicans. The number one for Democrats can be, bring change. The number one for Republicans stands for beliefs. I mean, do you see a dramatic split in how this general election is going to shape up?
You do, but that's a pretty typical difference between the parties and their approach to the overall looking at a candidate, in that the way the Republicans and Democrats both look for the candidate. And I think that's one of the things that is going to play out and why you do see a lot of fluctuation in the numbers looking towards the general election. But back to the original point, which is how this is going to play out and what the ultimate Democrat nominee brings about for the November, and how the issues that McCain stands on or Obama or Clinton stands on. One of the key numbers from the Fox poll that I thought was so fascinating was 1 in 5 Obama voters are actually a vote against Clinton, and 1 in 6 Obama voters would say that Democrats say they would never vote for Obama. So I think what you're going to see is the way in which this plays itself out for November, and getting back to the issues that McCain and Obama stand for, is the divisiveness of the Democratic primary is really creating a difficult challenge for them as they move into the fall.
Bernard, the Washington Post ABC poll that just came out in Ohio and Texas, this is last week, really showed things tightening up. In Ohio, Clinton is up 50% to 43%, and there you see in Texas, it's essentially a dead heat. That doesn't bode well for the Clinton campaign, right?
Well, I think that we're going to see Obama likely take Texas and Clinton likely take Ohio. But, one thing that is very heartening to me, again, as we look towards the fall, is I don't think there's a single person, except maybe my buddy Mark McKinnon, who is excited or enthusiastic about John McCain running for president. I don't even think Chris is excited about McCain running for president. We have what I think will be the starkest contrast in modern American political history between what is likely to be an Obama-McCain matchup. And with Obama's momentum continuing to build, I think come the fall, we are going to be in a very strong position. And whether this election ultimately turns on the economy and it turns on Iraq, and if things end up getting worse in Iraq, that's going to work in Obama's favor. If things end up continuing to improve in Iraq, that's also going to work in Obama's favor as the attention turns to the economy. And you've got a candidate on the Republican side, John McCain, who by his own admission doesn't know a whole lot about economics.
Chris, last word here. People are a little tired of polls after this season. Do you think as we head into the general election, polls will get more defined, better, because these issues will be so separate between Republicans and Democrats?
Well, they are. I don't think people ever get tired of polls. Otherwise, we'd never be on. But I admire Bernard's enthusiasm and optimism about the Democrats, but I would argue dramatically. And again, getting back to the numbers you cited a little bit ago from the Washington Post numbers, you look at the divisiveness that is taking place in the Democratic primary with African Americans supporting Clinton, supporting Obama, Hispanics supporting Clinton. Those rifts are not going to be healed overnight. And I think because of that, you are going to see some non-traditional constituencies look at voting for a Republican that may not have that opportunity, probably wasn't there before this primary got as heated as it did on the Democrat side.
Okay, Chris, Bernard, thanks very much for being here.
Thanks, Brett.